Did you know that Earth and Venus are about the same size and composition, yet the Earth has plate tectonics and Venus does not? Do you wonder why Mars has a liquid core, but no magnetic field and almost no atmosphere? Did the Moon once have a stable magnetic field, or was it like a light switch that turned on and off? All of these questions are fundamental to geodynamics, a subfield of geophysics. Geodynamics focuses on the underlying physical processes that drive plate tectonics and other geophysical phenomena on Earth, as well as similar processes on other solid planets and moons in our solar system. Geodynamicists are geophysicists that ask the large-scale questions, how does it work, and why does it work? Geodynamicists investigate how Earth's internal processes relate to what we see at the surface. Geophysical processes that we might experience, like earthquakes and volcanoes, are driven by plate tectonics from the Earth's interior. The Earth has a solid crust, a solid but flexible mantle, and a liquid outer core, all surrounding a solid inner core made of iron and nickel. As the planet rotates, the liquid outer core moves, creating strong electrical currents that generate Earth's magnetosphere. The Earth's magnetosphere makes our planet habitable because it deflects solar wind. Unlike the atmospheric wind we experience on Earth, solar wind is a stream of electrically charged particles coming from the sun, which without having a magnetosphere could destroy our atmosphere and be harmful to life on Earth. In fact, if we didn't have a magnetosphere, our planet would look a lot like Mars. When particles from the solar wind enter our atmosphere at the poles, where the Earth's magnetosphere is weakest, we see the aurora borealis and the aurora australis, the northern and southern lights. The more powerful gusts of solar wind can give rise to short-lived disturbances that may form geoelectric fields as they interact with not just the atmosphere, but the Earth's surface. During an intense solar storm, geoelectric fields induced in the rock can interfere with power grids and radio and satellite communications. To understand where these blackouts are most likely to occur, it is important to study the conductivity of rocks, or how electricity flows through them. Some rocks conduct electricity more than others as a result of their composition, formation, or depth. For example, rocks with certain kind of iron minerals, like iron sulfide, will conduct more electricity than those without iron. Geophysicists measure changes in Earth's magnetic and electric fields over time by conducting magnetotelluric surveys. Geodynamicists use these surveys, in combination with their knowledge of the planet's history, to construct electrical conductivity models of Earth's interior. Modeling what can happen to the Earth during magnetic storms can help narrow the locations with increased potential for geoelectric hazard and focus interventions. Geodynamicists also study the way gravity varies around the Earth. Specialized equipment like gravimeters can measure how the composition of the Earth's interior and the geologic features that we see at Earth's surface affect gravitational pull. Gravity is a function of mass, so areas with more dense rock will have measurably higher gravity than those with less dense rock. In turn, density is affected by temperature, so rocks that are melted into magma will be less dense than cool, solid rocks of the same composition. Geodynamicists use both of these properties to model where new volcanic islands may form. Deep inside the Earth, plumes of heat cause the mantle to rise, melt, and form volcanoes at the surface. Tectonic plates move over these stationary plumes, which gives rise to volcanic island chains, such as the Hawaiian Islands. Geodynamicists model both tectonic plate movement and mantle plume development to make their predictions. While Earth's highest temperatures are deep inside the planet, the pattern of heat from the core to the mantle to the crust is complex. Geodynamicists study heat flow through the Earth to map the location of geothermal resources, like heat for energy or minerals that only form at the highest temperatures. This affects not only how we power our modern society, but the minerals and materials that make it work. Geodynamic models can also be used with climate and tectonic models to better understand our changing climate. They might track how changes in global ice masses change the land surface, not just the water level of rising seas. Geodynamicists work with magnetism, electricity, gravity, and temperature data on Earth, but they also use data from probes, rovers, and telescopes to answer the large-scale questions on other planets, often working alongside astrophysicists and planetary geophysicists. In May 2022, the Mars InSight rover recorded the largest seismic event ever observed on that planet. Using what they know about the behavior of seismic waves on Earth, geophysicists can refine their understanding of the depth and composition of Mars' crust, mantle, and core. Geodynamicists can build on these interpretations to ask, how does it work and why does it work on Mars, our moon, and beyond? Whether it's studying the Earth or other planets, understanding plate tectonics or the role of climate change, geodynamics is an active and adapting field that requires many talented people to ask the big questions that propel science forward.